Pleasure to welcome you to the moving up ceremony It is so wonderful to see all the beautiful pieces. I believe the last time that I greeted you was at your sixth grade orientation. Right? You were the last group of students that I was able to see before the pandemic. So this welcome is heartfelt. I am truly proud of all that you have accomplished. You are motivated, hardworking, and most of all, resilient. I salute you for all that you have been able to achieve. I am honored to welcome you, your parents, family members, friends, and most importantly, students to this wonderful ceremony. As you embark in your next chapter of your academic journey, we are proud and confident that Queen's Gateway to Health Sciences has prepared you for a life of responsible citizenship, educated decision-making, and ethical leadership. We will miss some of you greatly as you move on to other schools. But we are super excited for all of you that will be moving on to high school with us next year. I know that you will accomplish great things in not only high school, but college and beyond. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ms. Rector. We are now calling Ms. Wahida Amin for a salutatory address as your salutatorian for the class of 2022.
Welcome, guest principal, assistant principal, teachers, and staff members to the Queen's Gateway to Health Sciences Secondary School Class of 2022 moving up ceremony. I must say, without a doubt, that each and every one of you significantly contributed to the success of our fellow classmates, which is why I decided to speak for the classmates in regards to their efforts, as well as the tremendous amount of support they received from the wonderful Queen's Gateway to Health Sciences Secondary School community.
Sorry.
From Queen's Gateway to Health Sciences Secondary School, we learned how the willingness to learn and collaboration are the roots of success. No matter our initial level of intelligence, since we had the mindset of seizing every opportunity possible, we were ultimately able to make it, which I find to be understandable and yet so astonishing. After all, we all knew that life is full of challenges. Those that we knew we would stumble upon, and those that were, in one word, unpredictable. From previous years, we knew that as each day passed by, we were gradually approaching the most difficult exams, such as the SHSAT for some, and the Regents. However, when I was in sixth grade, I had no idea that I would ever have to acknowledge a virus known as COVID-19. When I first heard about COVID-19, I was shocked to learn that we would have to become remote, in which we would not be able to be physically present while engaging in classroom discussions, assisting each other in group projects, and so forth. During the COVID-19 pandemic, numerous families had encountered the loss of their loved ones, a loss that is unexplainable through words. Although such loss was challenging to experience, it taught us how, despite the fact that we would undergo adversities in life, those struggles should not make you feel as if they are permanent. Furthermore, you should not let your socioeconomic status cause you to feel as if you're set for failure. If your family is struggling with financial stability, do not perceive yourself to be poor. For what matters most is who you grow up to become and the contributions you make to society, not money. Whenever you do not expect the best, you only hinder yourself from being able to prove the world that there is potential within yourself. Instead, misfortune should pave the way for greater empowerment, in which we would not stretch our arms to the sky to reach for opportunities, but opportunities would come down to nourish our needs, our hurts. How does that work exactly? Before we ask such an inquiry, let's think it this way. We already helped each other gain confidence through actions such as finding ways to communicate with each other even if we could not meet each other in person. And when we all returned to school, our teachers, as well as students, proved how education is not all about exams, but classroom discussions, clarifying questions, making mistakes, building upon them through the spread of wisdom, exploring enrichments, encouragement, motivation, and forming powerful connections and bonds with each other. In regards to advice I have for the classmates, always manage your time wisely and do not procrastinate. But wasting time is robbing oneself in terms of one's school capabilities. I would also like to advise social media users to make it their goal over the summer break to cut down on their usage, since it would usually end up being obstacles within our pathways of further educating ourselves. Of course, I cannot deny how excellent performance cannot be maintained academically without proper consideration of our well-being, whether it is about our mental health, physical health, spiritual health, and much more. As a result, I would like to emphasize the significance of also providing ourselves with a little break sometimes to be able to ensure a stable mind and soul. Without balance, one cannot be like this effectively. All of these factors demonstrate a student's spirit to learn, elaborate in an atmosphere filled with the wealth of the most enormous gift that no student would ever feel ungrateful for. Knowledge. Truly, knowledge is power, and all of you, 8th graders of the class of 2022, are empowered flowers of leadership, patience, perseverance, resilience, being indefatigable, and ultimate excellence. Congratulations.
We'd now like to welcome our principal, Ms. Judy A. Henry, for a message to the class of 2022. Family are here today. They've always been there for you.
sincerely thank you for your support, your sacrifice, your dedication to the job of parenting. It is the hardest job with no handle. And it's on days like today that you are able to see the light and say to yourself, I think I'm on the right path. Students, with every success, there is hard work. And it's dedication to get you into this world. I say to you, a lifelong learner, just as you dream, you learn, you endure. Tomorrow marks the beginning of a new chapter in your life as you emerge as young men and women with integrity and fortitude. Among the hope I have for you is that each of you, each and every one of you, as you transition to high school, contribute in both ways that are small and great to the future of our humanity. Respect. Respect all that you do and say. Respect others, even when you are not respected. Maintain your self-respect at all times, even when facing multiple challenges. Your dreams and aspirations will not always be smooth. You will have difficulties. You will face challenges. Do not be discouraged. Review, regroup, refresh your plans, and continue on your path. Each person's success will be different, but always be the best that you can be. Do not allow anyone to control your destiny, because then you will live with regrets. Live consistently with hope. Hope in the future, hope in your future, and hope in yourself. It is okay to stumble and fall. When you do, get up, dust yourself off, and continue the path. Continue the work. Continue the journey. As you start high school career, I ask that you think carefully about the choices that you will make. Make wise choices. The choices you make in high school will impact your early adult life. Students, you have worked hard. Be proud of yourselves, as I am proud of you. I am especially proud of our valedictorian sophomore. Stand up, they can acknowledge. Do not allow frivolous distractions to steer you away from your dreams and aspirations. President Obama, in his address on Tuesday, February 24th, 2009, said, and I quote, "Dropping out of high school is no longer an option. It's not just quitting on yourself, it's quitting on your country. And this country needs and values the talents of every American, every one of you sitting here. Never give up. Class of 2022, congratulations, good luck, and best wishes."
Thank you very much, Ms. Henry, for those words. We are now going to welcome your valedictorian for a valedictory address, Ms. Zafna Munaisa.
Good afternoon. I am honored to welcome all parents, teachers, and as well as other members of the faculty and distinguished guests to the Queen's Gateway to the Health Sciences Secondary School Moving Up Ceremony. I'm glad all of us can make it today. It was a long journey. Today, I stand before you delivering the speech on the 8th grade valedictorian of Queen's Gateway. I was in absolute shock when I first was informed that the honor of being this year's valedictorian was bestowed upon me. I couldn't process the news within 5 seconds. This honor is a milestone moment for me for countless reasons, many of which you can perceive. One thing's for sure, with great privilege comes even greater responsibility. Soon after, I was notified that one of those responsibilities would be to speak in front of you today. That meeting includes my family members, some of my closest friends and colleagues, teachers and administrators who have known me for years, and while there could not have been a greater privilege than to stand before you today, I do have stage fright. I'll do my best to overcome this year this afternoon at this momentous occasion. As I mentioned before, it was a long road here. While we graduates have so many to thank for helping us get to where we are on this day, I'd like to start by thanking all of the parents, especially my father in the audience, who made it here to see us graduates participate in what may as well be the greatest accomplishments of our lives thus far. Unfortunately, my mother could not make it today, but she has always been and still is my number one supporter. Believe it or not, families and friends have contributed significantly to our success. Although we were under pressure to meet high expectations, our parents pushed us to try our hardest to obtain the greatest achievements. They knew our potential and encouraged us to do our best through a delicate balance of comforting words and harsh commentary. In the end, I strongly believe that all parents have the same goal in mind, to see their child succeed. After a couple of months post-fifth grade graduation, it was suddenly my first day of sixth grade. I don't think there's a word to convey my feeling when I first stepped foot into middle school. However, I do know I was very anxious but also exhilarated by the thought that a new school meant a fresh start. It wasn't as bad as I expected it to be. As humorous as Dr. B is, he became my favorite teacher. Not sure if he remembers me though. I was one of the 3-star students in 602 at that house. Anyhow, one of my favorite events that I was able to experience at Queen's Gate was the assembly that took place on Multicultural Days yesterday. It's probably the one event I found entertaining before the global pandemic emerged. I was able to see the diversity of different cultures all together in one show. I found it to be a way to learn about various cultures through performances, and I hope there are more of these events for current and incoming middle schoolers. A little over half our first year of middle school, the rise of a virus arose known as COVID-19. It quickly spread worldwide, causing the global population to decrease drastically. In order to keep people safe and have time to create the proper medication for it, we were under lockdown, which then turned into complete quarantine. Due to this, we were unable to attend school in person, and as a result, had to resort to online learning. In all honesty, online learning was significantly disorganized. Not everyone knew what to do, what they needed, or where to search for information. Furthermore, I'm sure many of us, myself included, were unmotivated to get anything done because being quarantined felt the same as being trapped in a cage. Moreover, 6 hours of school meant 6 hours of screen time. It didn't stop there, though. There were assignments and homework to complete, which added more screen time. I remember I was so exhausted to the point of passing out all time. Despite all the hardships all of us had to go through last year and the year before, it was all worth it. We're all here now, at school, in person, ready to move on to high school. It's incredible how so much can happen in a short period of time. Lastly, exceptionally hard just to have to attend schools that may not be able to inspire them both academically and creatively. But it's okay, because although the school may have a terrible reputation or a low ranking, I'm confident that our outgoing 8th grade class can make a positive difference in these schools. I'm excited to see many students from our graduating class improve schools from all around the city. This may require starting from scratch and rebuilding, but our future deserves it. Now, for those of us who were accepted into schools that you have always looked forward to attending, congratulations. You all deserve it, and I hope we continue to strive in the future. I consider it a privilege to be your colleague and have you. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much. We want to again want to congratulate you, Zafka, for the excellent work. We're now going to call up your guidance counselor, your confidant, your friend, for the Class of 2022 awards to be read by Ms. Nessie. Thank you.
a great salutatorian and excellence in art.
Calling the names of the eighth grade graduates. The first group will be read by Ms. Frackleberry. First, grade one, please start to line up.
Leonardo Ramchandran. Raynard Ramsaru. Ashley Rosales.
Martha Badra. Navinita Biswas. Anik Ramachari. Ileana Cruz. Donboy Das. Zendik Dorji. Sarah Hassan. Most Jahan. Anawara Khan. Ethan Kumar. Lucy Navia Kios. Nafisa Nova. Pryanti Paul. Sneha Puspa. Shady Ramda. Nikki Runabout. Aiden Ruffin. Saba MSC. Santiago, sorry, D'Amelio Santiago. Ariana Sudo. AJ Supersong. Gershuron Singh. Priya Singh. Mantaha Sultana. Zakna Lisa. Jannat Waratum.
Tamir Ahmed. Chelsea Boudram. Tawfiq Bukhari. Samiha Chowdhury. Jeremiah Cope. Descartes. Cheyenne Dewan. Malik Dijasi. Harif Faisal. Ola Galloway. Thank you. Valencia. Rayon Salahuddin.
I'm now going to call two students to the stage to assist in the recitation of the Abhimic Pledge with Nikki Runabot and Tabir Ahmed. Say a special thank you to the eighth grade that I've had the pleasure and the honor of working with and teaching this year, some of you in the last 2 years. You know, in history, we always say that it's something that it's not just something that we learn. Ladies and gentlemen, you are living through history. And it's something that every one of you can make. Remember that. Remember where we came from. Remember where we are. And use it to think about the future we want it to be. I want to thank you. I want to thank all the parents, because again, without you, this could not be done. I'm going to ask the graduating class to please rise as we process out. Thank you. Everyone, thank you. You may meet your children outside. I wish you all the best. And have a great summer. Thank you.
Back then it's about that. এদিকে টাকা রাখতে বাইরে আসো তোমার মা তো বাইরে যাওয়া পড়লো চলো বাইরে গেল কেনা চলো চলো আসো তাহলে বাইরে আসো আসো
চলো